I don't like Islam. And I reject Sharia law outright. Muhammad can kiss my ass, and Allah is a figment of that particular lunatic's diseased imagination. With my Islamophobic credentials now firmly established, I'd like to proceed to highlight some things that have begun to worry me greatly. The things we say about Muslims, and how we say them, are frankly beginning to unnerve me. In particular, the sinister circulation and recirculation of anecdote as fact. The inflation of single incidents into a myriad of breathlessly retold horror stories. For example, that Muslims rape Western women specifically to make a point, or are attempting a coordinated demographic takeover of the European Union. Atheists should have a greater respect for the facts. This is our claim to fame, so to speak, and yet on this subject, and in this area, the analysis seems to be completely missing. There are currently about 25 million Muslims in Christian Europe, within a population of 500 million. That's right, roughly about 5%. You'd think it was at least 30% plus, wouldn't you? If the wildest demographic projections imagined occur, and France, for example, becomes a majority Muslim country in 2050, assuming we still have a planet, would this actually mean Sharia law? Let's think about the underlying assumptions here for a second. 1. That all French Muslims, the recently reached 51% majority, will vote for a single party, or parties with platforms basically indistinguishable from each other. 2. That these parties will promise Sharia law. 3. That these elected representatives will then live up to their promises. Currently, less than 50% of European Muslims themselves are keen to live under Sharia law. It would require a population density of 80% plus to get even the most banal elements of Sharia passed into law. This ignores, of course, the elapse of 50 years, the elements that would require constitutional changes, or EU-wide referenda. Yes, Islamic fundamentalists are among us. Yes, a minority of lunatics want to kill us, eat our babies, rape our women, and enslave us all to Allah. However, they can't. They lack the numbers, they lack the support, and let's face it, they're nuts. Critically, the majority of Muslims are people, just like you and me. They couldn't care less about much of this stuff, and frankly, I see plenty of signs of them losing patience with their clerical class, most notably in Iran. The portrayal of Muslims as a kind of religious Borg collective, to a man voting in unvarying unison, in 50 years' time, of course, when the demographics stack up, is beyond absurd. A casual glance at Iraq, and the deep and abiding differences among Muslims there, all too readily evidenced by the ongoing carnage, should disabuse even the most hysterical among us. Muslims have become, albeit somewhat self-inflicted, a demonized global minority. They lack the military, economic, and political capacity to mount a serious threat to global civilization. They make up roughly 1.5 billion of the world's 6.7 billion citizens, but account for a much smaller percentage of economic activity. The fastest growing regions economically and by population are, of course, now in China and India, both minority Muslim regions. Culture is not static. It moves and shifts and changes. It's in constant flux. This is not something to fear, but to embrace. And you best buckle up, Dorothy, because we are on an exponential curve to somewhere, but the 14th century, it ain't. The world is going to keep changing, and I will continue to resist efforts from all religious quarters to enshrine liturgical lunacy into law. I will also continue to insist on evidence-based reasoning from all quarters, and especially from the atheist community. Pat Condell was right to raise the issue about the mayor of Brussels cancelling a peaceful protest for bad reasons. I agree with him on the principle of the thing. However, I don't like the overall tone, and I don't like the mob hysteria I see in the comments. Pogroms don't just happen to Jews. They happen to any sufficiently demonized outgroup. Highlighting a readily identifiable minority as evil, inhuman, or a threat in a rapidly globalizing world, with a series of resource crunches on the horizon, is very, very dangerous. Just ask the Rwandans, or the Bosnians, or the Serbs for that matter. By all means, call a spade, but leave your hysterics at the door and check the facts. Always.